Today we are going to see the active and the passive sentence in the continuous tense and in the perfect tense. The first one is the present continuous tense. Present continuous tense, the verb will be with auxiliary verb plus ing in the active voice. When it changes to passive, we are going to use the be form of the verb being. It shows that the continuous tense in the passive. In active continuous tense, it will be like auxiliary plus verb plus ing. For example, we can say is writing, are writing. When it changes to passive, is being written, are being played. We have to use like that. See the first sentence, we are buying vegetables. We is a subject, are buying is verb, vegetables object. So, SVO pattern. We have to change that into OVS. First, we are going to write vegetables. It is a plural. So, we are going to use the auxiliary verb are. Then, being. Then, V3. Buy, bought, bought. And the connective word buy. And V changes to us. So, the answer is vegetables are being bought by us. Then see the second example, Shanti is writing memory poems. Here, memory poems are the plural. So, we are going to use our auxiliary and the being and the V3 form return by Shanti. Memory poems are being returned by Shanti. So, in the past continuous, same like in the present we are going to write, but the auxiliaries alone is going to be changed. In the past continuous, the verb form is in active, was drinking, were reading. Here we are going to use being to change that active to passive. See the example of first one, she was singing a song. Was singing is a verb, she is a subject, object is a song. So the answer is a song was being sung by her. See the second example, the teacher was correcting the papers. Here the teacher is a subject, was correcting is a verb, the answer papers. So object you are going to write first, the answer papers were being corrected by the teacher. And then now we are going to see the perfect tense. Perfect means we are going to use has, have, had in the active voice. Has, have, had follows the V3 form of the verb, that is past participle. When it changes to the passive, we have to use has been, have been, had been. In the present perfect, be form of the verbs, we are going to use been. If it is in the active, we are going to use has written, have written. Has is used for singular, have is used for plural. See the examples I have written here. The principal has called the students. Here in the active voice I have written has called. Has follows the past participle. Here no need to search for the past participle. Just we are going to add been in between has and called. So the answer is, first we are going to write the object, the students. It is a plural. So we are going to use have. The students have been called by the principal. See the second example, the postman has returned the parcel. Here, the parcel has been returned by the postman. See the next, past perfect. Past perfect, you are going to use had plus V3 in active. Here, had returned. Both singular and plural subject, we are going to use had, V3 form. So, when you are writing this in the passive, we are going to write had, been, V3 of the verb. Example, see the example, the first one. She had answered the questions. She had answered the questions. Had answered is a verb. She is the subject. The question is an object. The question had been answered by her. So, the second example. She had done the project. The project had been done by him. Next, future perfect. In future perfect, we are going to use will or shall plus V3 in passive. Will or shall have plus been. Example, the postman will have delivered the letters. Will have delivered will change to will have been delivered. The letters will have been delivered by the postman. See the second example. I shall have learned the martial art. I shall have learned. Shall have learned. Because we are using shall here, I follows shall. I and we. So we used shall. When you are writing as an object the martial art, we are going to use will. Shall have learned changes to will have been learned. The martial art will have been learned by me. First, we have written all the sentence with one object. Now I have given one example for you to write with the two objects. Direct object and indirect object. For an example, my father presented me a gift. To identify the object, we ask a question, what? For the direct object. The two object as given, we have to go with whom. My father presented me a gift. Me is an indirect object. A gift is a direct object. We can write the answer in two ways. See the answer. A gift was presented to me by my father. Or we can write, I was presented a gift by my father. In the second sentence, see here, it is understood that if an object is not there, we can change that sentences. Someone stole my cycle. My cycle is an object here. Stole is a verb. Here, my cycle was stolen. I have written as my cycle was stolen. Either you can write by someone. But here, it is understood that somebody has taken the cycle. So, we can stop the sentence. See the sentence, imperative sentence. In imperative, we have two types. One is transitive and intransitive. If it is in an intransitive verb, then you are going to use you are requested. See, I have given her some examples here. Please don't scribble on the bench. It is an imperative sentence with intransitive verb. That means here there is no object. So you are going to write, you are requested not to scribble on the bench. Why we are using not to? Because it is in the negative. Don't is given. So we are using not to. Walk on the pavement. It is also an imperative sentence with intransitive verb. But it is a positive. So we are not going to use not to. We are going to use to. You are requested to walk on the pavement. See with the interrogative sentences. In interrogative sentences, first question I have written here. Who broke the window? Who changes to by whom? Was the window broken? At the last you have to use the question mark. The pattern of the question is, you have to write like this. First question word. Then you have to write the auxiliary, then the subject and the verb, etc. And here also, we should retain the same pattern even in the passive voice. See the second example. Which language did you speak? Here, did plus speak, spoke. I have written some do form of the verbs how to change. Do plus speak, speak. Did plus speak, spoke. Does plus speak, speaks. Here, speak and speaks is the present tense. Did plus speak, spoke is the past tense. Past tense, we are going to use the auxiliaries was and were. Because here, did speak is given. So, spoke, past tense. So, the answer is, which language was spoken by you? And see, do form of the verbs. Here, in the do form of the verbs question, do you complete the work? Here, do complete. Means complete. That is in the present tense. Here you are going to use be form of the verb is are. Here the work is an object. It is a singular. So we are going to use is. Is the work completed by you? See next another example. Have you completed the homework? It has to change. Has the homework been completed by you? And then see the models. Models can, could, shall, should, will, would, may, might, must. Here, when you change this into passive voice, you have to write be. Be form of the verb, be should be added. For example, can be returned, should be returned, etc. Say, I have given some examples here. We should help the poor. Should help changes to should be helped. The poor should be helped by us.
See the second example. You must write the homework. The homework must be written by you. And some imperative sentences with the transitive verb. See the example. Close the door. It is a transitive verb. When it is a transitive verb, how can I identify the transitive verb? The object is given, the door. So, if it is a transitive, we are going to use let. Let the door be closed. See the next sentence. Clean your shoes. Let your shoes be cleaned. See in the boxes for all the sentences. Tenses I have given like a formula. Here also let plus object plus be plus verb 3. Listen children, are you clear?